There are several distinct atmospheric levels above the Earth. Each level is characterized by changes in temperature with elevation. These differences are attributable to the concentration of the gases in these layers, as well as the proximity to heat-absorbing and reflective bodies. From the Earth to outer space, these layers are known as the following: the troposphere, the stratosphere, the mesosphere, and the thermosphere. Between each layer is a pause or boundary between the gradients where the temperature is stable. However, above the pauses, the temperature changes fairly rapidly. The troposphere is the layer nearest the Earth and of great interest to air quality studies. It extends about 6 miles upward, although this height varies depending on where it's measured and the Earth between the poles and the equator. It contains life-supporting oxygen and other gases that moderate the temperature of the Earth. It is also a volatile area where there is much mixing due to the pressure differences that are caused by solar radiation. Normally, in the troposphere, temperatures decrease with elevation. However, as we will study this term, there are times there is a reverse in the temperature-altitude relationship. This situation is a temperature inversion and can have implications with the movement of air, and is especially troublesome if there are pollutants trapped in the air. The next vertical layer begins the upper atmosphere, and the initial zone here is the stratosphere. In this zone, that goes from about 6 to 30 miles in height, the temperature rises with elevation. Stratospheric ozone, 3 bonded atoms of oxygen, is critical in filtering out certain solar ultraviolet rays that would otherwise harm life on Earth. We will study how this zone has been altered by man-made chemicals. The last two layers, the mesosphere and the thermosphere, both play important roles in protecting the Earth from excessive electromagnetic radiation.